Hello everyone, this is Chiranjit Chil and you are watching DIGI classes. And the today's topic is Consumer's Equilibrium and Law of Diminishing Marginal Utility. In the previous video, we have already discussed about utility and its various types. So if you have not watched that video, so watch that video first to understand this video better. So let's start Consumer's Equilibrium. A consumer is said to be in equilibrium when he gets maximum satisfaction by spending his given income. It means consumer's equilibrium refers that point from where the consumer don't want to move. That is why this equilibrium is also known as point of balance. That means at that point the consumer is getting his maximum satisfaction with his given income. So consumer's equilibrium, there are so many cases we are going to discuss here, mainly about the single commodity case. And there are another case, that is two commodity case. In this video, we are going to discuss elaborately only the single commodity case. So let's start the video. So consumer's equilibrium in case of single commodity, and the condition is MUX equals to PX. It means the marginal utility of good X should become equal to the price of good X. It means that the consumer will continue his purchasing until his utility becomes equal to the price level. In the schedule, we can see that here it is marginal utility of good X, and here it is price level of good X. And at the units of consumption, in the fifth number, we get MUX equals to PX, that is 10. Or the condition can be written in another form, that is MUX divided by PX equals to MUM equals to 1. This is also the condition of consumer's equilibrium. Let's understand it. MUX by PX equals to MUM. MUM refers the marginal utility of money. Marginal utility of money refers an extra satisfaction when a consumer spends an extra amount of money. So we can find, using this formula here, MUM equals to MUX divided by PX. That means 20, in case of 1, 20 divided by 10, that is 2. Here we can write 2, then 2.2, then 1.8, then 1.4, then 1, then 0.8, 0.6. Here it is seen that at the fifth units of consumption, it becomes 1. MUM becomes 1. So the condition fulfills here. And from the schedule, we can draw the diagram. And in the diagram, this is the MUX curve. This is the MUX curve, and this is the PX curve, which is equal to the 10, rupees 10. And at point E, it becomes equilibrium at the fifth units of consumption. At the fifth unit of consumption, PX becomes equal with MUX. So hopefully understand this concept, and let's start the another concept, law of diminishing marginal utility. So here we start the next concept, law of diminishing marginal utility, and here is the definition. When a consumer goes on consuming more and more of a particular commodity, the marginal utility goes on diminishing. Suppose you are consuming or drinking Coca-Cola or Pepsi, then the first units of consumption gives you highest level of satisfaction than the second level, because by consuming a same commodity, you will get the less satisfaction or less utility from the earlier. So every economic theory has some assumptions. Here, for the applicability of the theory of law of diminishing marginal utility, it has also some assumptions. Here, the first assumption is continuity. Continuity here refers that the consumer has to consume the particular commodity continuously. And the second point is rationality. Here, rationality refers that the consumer has the knowledge that whether she is gaining or losing the satisfaction or utility by consuming the same commodity. And the third point is that cardinal utility. It means that utility should be measurable in quantity manner. Now here is the table or schedule units, and it is marginal utility, and we can understand better this table with the help of this diagram. Here it is seen that the marginal utility is diminishing, and at the 6 units of consumption, marginal utility becomes 0, and here the consumer gets its maximum satisfaction, that means full satisfaction point. So hopefully you will understand the concept of marginal utility and the law of diminishing marginal utility. So thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe to our channel.